Welcome. Today's tip is all about airflow and the effect that it has on air conditioning and the AC pressures, as we'll illustrate using the gauges here. So in a lot of vehicles today, we've got some sort of a fan clutch, whether it be electroviscous or a complete viscous fan clutch here, or sometimes we've also got an electric fan here. We're gonna draw air through a series of coolers, the AC condenser, the radiator, and cool all this. And airflow is king here. However, in the real world, we see a lot of times where there's aftermarket grills or different bumpers or something changed in the front of the vehicle that's gonna reroute the airflow here. And that does have an effect on the AC system. While the vehicle may not appear to be overheating, it's gonna have some effect on the AC system. So we look at our F-250 here today, and already, I mean, the plastic air dam that goes between the upper shroud here and the radiator has been ripped apart, and it's not in the best shape. So I'm gonna do a little illustration here, just using some shop towels to show you the effect of the airflow on the AC pressure. So the truck idling about 900 RPM right now. My high side is, let's say 180, and my low side is holding at 25 PSI. So I'm just gonna take these rags and hold them up in front of the AC condenser here. And as you can tell, fan's doing its job. It's drawing some good air. And so I've just created a restriction on the condenser here. Similar to, I've seen a lot of times where you get the cotton floating through the air from some of the different trees or different road debris. Contaminates the condenser here, restricts that airflow. And right away, if we look at our pressures now, my high side has climbed to 2.25, about 230 already, and my low side has already increased to 30 PSI, simply by creating this minimal restriction. There's still other ways for it to get through here, but it's made a great impact on my pressures. So if I remove the rags here, allow some good airflow to get across this condenser again, my pressures are returning back to where they were previously. Now if I go one step further and kind of create some sort of an air dam along the side here, so air's not gonna escape anywhere else, and it's gonna be drawn specifically through here, now my pressures drop down that much further. And so we've made a drastic improvement on our pressures here, or a drastic change on our pressures, simply by allowing more or less air to flow across the AC condenser here. So hopefully this little illustration rings a bell next time you're working on AC diagnostics where the pressures aren't quite the way they should be. Always make sure that we've got good proper airflow across the entire condenser here. No restrictions. Make sure all the air dams are in place. Make sure even the air dams below the bumper are in place to help route the air through the condenser properly. Thanks for tuning in. Be sure to check our YouTube channel for additional tips similar to this.